beautiful lionesses. I'm happy to be live here in this group today, as it is Sunday, and I truly just consciously want to take a break from my personal page today and come and share here. And tomorrow, it'll be a new day and I can go live on my personal page with the prompt and speak about two prompts at once. So what I wanted to share today is a little message from a card deck, the Divine Feminine. It's one of my favorite, a really beautiful Divine Feminine Oracle deck that's created from many, many Divine Feminine archetypes and women, goddesses of all kinds. And a lot of these beautiful goddesses are real life history, historical figures. Incredible. I've pulled so many beautiful messages out of this book. And today, I wanted to challenge a little bit. You know, I'm working, currently working really deeply with a mother goddess archetype, specifically Sophia, the ancient mother goddess of us all, and in the way of a consciousness, like a cosmic mother consciousness. I have noticed that I have always connected to this mother archetype in all the books. I always had like this tender emotional place for the archetype of the mother. And when I discovered a cosmic mother energy like this, I also want to name it Christ Sophia consciousness, like the divine feminine Christ consciousness. Oh, it truly landed in my soul and just really settled in, because I have always felt myself to be such a motherly woman. You know, in one of my friendship relationship that is currently no longer a friendship in my life, by this beautiful friend of mine, I was told that my motherly ways are suffocating. And at the time, it hurt me. It hurt me to read that. And I truly now come to realizing that it only suffocates those who are triggered by my blessing energy. And so I know that energy I possess of a blessing, of a mother, of this nurturing, welcoming, nourishing force. And I truly stand by it. I own it. I embody it. I claim it. And if it triggers anyone and they want to run from it, I only want to welcome them back in and to show them truly this incredible, beautiful energy of the cosmic mother. So today I wanted to challenge that energy, and I said to myself, I'm seeking a proof, through the cards, like a proof that it exists. You know, I just wanted to challenge that in myself. And guess what card I pulled? Is Sarada Devi, and it's divine, the Divine Mother. Right under the name, it says the Divine Mother. Unconditional love, exists within me. The presence of love is the absence of judgment. The presence of love is the absence of judgment. This year, during one of my online courses that I did earlier in the summer, it was like late spring, summer, someone asked me a question about judgment, about being judgmental. And I remember feeling into the unconditional love, and the presence of love is the absence of judgment. So whenever we're feeling judgmental towards anyone or anything, we must invite the unconditional love to dissipate the judgment. So it's very powerful. Okay, so I want to read the message from the card, and then I'll feel into what else wants to come through. Sarada Devi, the Divine Mother, who she is. Shri Sarada Devi embodies the feminine power that initiates seekers onto a spiritual path through unconditional love. Sarada Devi was born in Jairambari, India, in 1853 to poor Brahmin parents. As a little girl, she worshipped a clay figurine of the goddess Kali, meditated, and began to have visions. At age 5, she was betrothed to the priest of the Dakshinewar Kali temple, a beloved mystic named Ramakrishna. 10 years later, she joined him at the temple, and they began their lifelong spiritual marriage together. Sarada's husband, Ramakrishna, performed the Shodashi Puja with her. This meant that Sarada was positioned in the seat of the goddess Kali and was addressed as Shri Ma, or Holy Mother. Sarada is considered to be Ramakrishna's first disciple. They both became notable mystics with large international followings. Sarada helped form the monastic order for the devotees of Ramakrishna after he passed. And because she was so beloved, a monastic order was founded for women in her honor. She paved the way for future generations of women to enter the spiritual life. As a guru, Sarada Devi was known for treating all her disciples as her children. Many of her devotees relate that she initiated them in a dream. She appeared as a goddess in human form and gave them a mantra. When they met her for the first time, they would recall the dream and know instantly they were encountering their guru. When your soul selects her card, Sarada Devi loved all her disciples unconditionally and equally. In her teachings, she emphasized that there is no such thing as a stranger. She encouraged her devotees to understand that everyone we meet is actually a part of us and is connected to us, and that if we want to experience true peace, we need to own the fault and judgment that we project onto others. We need to see our own faults and forgive them with love. Sarada Devi whispers gently to us, "No one is a stranger, my child. This whole world is your own." So if something keeps showing up in the people we meet and in the relationships we are cultivating, Sarada asks us to meet them from within us, meaning the aspects of this other person that might be causing us pain or frustration or just plain aversion, these same aspects exist within us. unless we're willing to really meet with these aspects within within us, the universe will keep presenting them to us in our relationships. And it's not to piss us off, it's to free us. It's out of a deep love for us to fully heal. The goal here is for us to love ourselves fiercely from within, without judgment or shame, for where we are in the moment. The goal is to let us mother ourselves with unconditional love. That's the only love that will quiet those harsh, critical voices within us, so we can stop wasting our time mired in judgment of others or ourselves and get on with being the perfectly imperfect light that we are. What am I currently judging or criticizing about myself? Yeah, I like this message. So whenever we judge someone else, we should truly turn within and ask, what am I judging within myself? However, I also want to speak on a little bit of the truth speaking, the truth message and the truth talking, that it's okay to call out injustice. And what we see is unjust in the world doesn't always mean it's inside of us. And once we've owned and embodied ourselves fully, we have a choice to rise and to stand up for truth, for justice, for humanity. So I wanted to add that. And intention of this card is unconditional love exists within me. The presence of love is the absence of judgment. Yeah, so I wanted to share that and to say that my hero would be a divine mother at this time. She's truly so powerful in her ability to create healing for the earth, to create healing for all who are suffering, her children. And in her cosmic way, she's able to spread her wings and to invite anyone who is suffering in any way, and for her to hold her children in her powerful, powerful healing embrace, and to transmute through her consciousness and her energy the pain and the wounds of any injustice upon the planet at this time. So I'm so grateful for my knowing of this cosmic mother within myself, and to truly turn within and to find that hero within myself, so that I may rise with my power to serve these children of our cosmic mother with my unconditional love, knowing that no one is a stranger and we're all a family, a cosmic family. So that's what I wanted to come and transmute, and thank you for receiving me. So many blessings.